Hey everyone, Dr. Edrich here, Heritage Hills Addiction Medicine and Mental Health, coming to you from the beautiful German city of Blaubeuern, which is an abbey, like a monastery, founded around the year 1000 with this beautiful spring. This is actually the spring of one of the rivers here in German, southern Germany, and this is where it comes out of the ground and then flows down through the cities. Beautiful place. As you can see, we all love to bicycle here a lot. A lot of people ask me why I'm here in Germany a lot. It's because this is where my family lives. My parents live here. My relatives live here. And so we come here a lot to visit them and be with them. Anyway, wanted to talk to you guys about the difference between pain management versus addiction with pain management. A lot of patients come to me as combination. They come with initially what was a pain management issue, maybe an injury or a long-term chronic problem that they were given opiates for by other doctors, unfortunately. That's where the opiate crisis came from. And now we've got this problem where they've got dependency, and then the addiction develops because they get hooked on it and they start using the medication, not just for the pain reasons, but a lot of people say it helps with other stuff too. So now we have pain management and addiction. The real question that a lot of patients have for me that they're really scared about is, if we get rid of the opiates, how do we deal with the pain management? Do we honor that? Do we acknowledge the fact that pain management even exists? And the answer, the short answer, is absolutely. We absolutely do honor the pain management aspect of it. We just have to find more optimal ways of doing it. When people have been led down the road of what I call iatrogenic addiction, which means physician-induced addiction. Doctors have given you guys opiates to try to help initially, well-intentioned maybe, but over time it's just easy to refill, and get people out of the office and not deal with the actual problem. That's where you guys get stuck. So you're carrying the burden of our mismanaged medical system. On behalf of all doctors, I apologize to you for that. That is not correct. So we have to figure out how we honor the fact that you have pain management needs. Are there other tools that we can use? The answer is absolutely. I always tell patients, look, what's the worst case scenario? The worst case scenario is we try to find something better for you. We try to find something that works more optimally for your pain control. We reduce the opiates, or we get rid of the opiates, or we use other medications like buprenorphine to not only help with the dependency part, but also works as a fabulous pain management tool. Buprenorphine was actually developed in Europe over here in 1982. It is not a new medication at all. It is very old, and it just took a long time to come over to the United States. So it's not a new medication. I'm not a big fan of jumping in on new medicines, but this is not a new one. Either way, there's a lot of tools we have for pain management. We got to look at all the other bits and pieces. Some people come in saying, I've tried everything already. Yes, but have you tried the right combination? Listen, I've tried cooking with all sorts of spices, and everything I cook turns to garbage. Therefore, my conclusion is all spices are garbage. That is not correct. Just because I haven't found the right combination to cook properly doesn't mean that a proper chef couldn't do it, okay? And that's all I'm saying is there are a lot of things out there that we can do for pain management, things that include medications like the anti-inflammatory medications, the neuropathic, the nerve pain medications, Neurontin, Gabapentin, Lyrica, Cymbalta. There's a lot of those types of tools. They're just tools. They're not magic, but they very well might make a massive difference for you. If they don't work, they don't work. Back to square one, you know? But what if they do work? That's my wish for you, is that we find something that does work, that helps you get away from the opiates. I always reassure patients, I'm not here to yank the opiates out from underneath you. If you try to go down this road and it doesn't work for you, you can always go back to opiates, I guess, you know? There's always ways of doing that. We don't want you to continue on opiates. Some people get away from 99% of all the opiates, and then we come down to what we consider a reasonable level. Like, say somebody has legitimate screws and plates and bars and stuff all over their body from surgeries. They might need long-term oxycodone, but not 300 milligrams, okay? Maybe in combination with physical therapy, neuropathic medications like Neurontin and Lyrica, in combination with older medications like amitriptyline, Elavil, cognitive behavioral therapy, pain-based cognitive behavioral therapy as well has been shown to help with pain management. Even the CBD products, not the THC, but the CBD component can be very useful in pain management as well. We can talk about all that stuff. Worst case scenario, I reassure people, look, it doesn't work and you're back to square one again. Best case scenario, it does work. We find something awesome for you. What if we can get you from 300 milligrams of oxy down to 20 or 40 or 60 milligrams? What if we could accomplish just that alone as well? We're not looking for perfection. We're not going to deny the fact that you have bolts and pins all the way through your body. But we're going to do the best we can to use everything in concert that works well together, synergistically. They help each other out. They augment each other. They complement each other, just like cooking. Spices are not meant to be used just one-handedly. They are meant to complement each other, okay? So if we say, hey, there's way too much sugar in your product, let's try to reduce the amount of sugar and get some other flavors in there. You know, we might be able to get a much better product just by creating, getting multiple flavors in there and thereby reducing the amount of actual sugar that's so bad for you. But not zero necessarily, but at least to a healthier level, okay? So that's what we really strive to. Best case scenario, we make it all the way off the opiates and you're only on other medications that play well nicely. And again, don't cause side effects. A lot of patients tell me they're really worried about side effects. That's a very legitimate thing. We don't want side effects. They can happen. Start low, go slow is always my policy here. And take your time. That way, if side effects show up, they're either benign or annoyingly just mild, and we let them go away. Or if they don't go away, we just go down a different pathway. We don't jump, you know, around medications like crazy. But it's just like cooking. You make a little change, you let it simmer for a while. You make another little change, you let that simmer for a while. You don't see a chef throwing in 10 different spices all at once. They don't do that. They do one thing at a time, and they don't wait too long to make another change, but they don't wait too short either. They wait just the right amount of time. How much time is that? That's my job. That's the chef's job. There's a sweet spot to how long every medication takes to settle in without going too hasty and without dawdling around and wasting too much time. So best case scenario, guys, again, get into the office, sit down with me or one of my wonderful PAs. They're phenomenal. We can walk you through all the options before you even decide to do anything. I've got people who come in saying, hey, I'm hooked on heroin, I'm hooked on oxycodone, I'm totally not ready to quit yet. I just want to hear the options. What options do you have? When and if I ever get ready for that, I might come back, I might not. That's all we're looking for. Get in, have that conversation, get educated about what's out there, and I'll tell you straight up. You know, I'll tell you straight exactly what the side effects are. Some things have side effects, some things don't. You know, we'll go through that. Opiates have a lot of side effects. There's 50,000 people dying every year from them. That's 127 47s crashing into the ground in the United States every year full of people on opiates. So when people say, well, all the other medicines have side effects, not as much as 127 47 airplanes crashing. That's a lot of side effects from one medication, you know? Like, that's using cayenne pepper for every single recipe that you have in way too high of a dose, okay? It's just not going to work. So, guys, get in. Let's have a conversation. Don't be afraid. We're not judgmental. We won't hold it against you. We're not going to criticize for why you need what you need. We're just here to give you options. Real simple. You guys have a wonderful weekend. Signing off. As usual, treat things right the first time, every time, all the time. Never cut corners. Talk to you later, guys. Bye.